So what we experience, Interstellar movie and dimensions. What we experience is four dimensions. Do you? Three dimensions of the time and space. Alright? And in space, in time also, whether we can only, time appears to be flowing from towards, I mean, it'll be flowing in one direction. So we can only see as things come. We cannot see the past. Time is flowing in one direction. Right? But time itself can be bidirectional, two directions also. The space is three dimensions, what we see. Now, these are four dimensions which we can experience. Are there more dimensions than this? And if they are there, can we experience it? Okay. So, the concept of dimension I will tell like this. Somebody sitting on top of a mountain. Okay. And that guy is able to see everything, road and all. One guy is coming very fast on the bike. Okay, and there's a big stone there. Okay, which this guy biker guy is not able to see because he is yet to see that stone. But the guy who is sitting on the mountain sees, okay, this guy is going to hit that stone. How does he see? How does he know? He is sitting on the top, and he is able to see the future of this guy there. He's going to die. He's able to see the future, right? Because he's slightly in a higher dimension compared to right? So we are in the three dimension. We are in the three dimension. For us, the future, what happens day after tomorrow, is yet to be seen. But somebody is in the higher dimension can see that now. Right? Okay. The tomorrow, what happened? What happens yesterday? What's going to happen yesterday? What happened? That past, present, and future, you can see for it can be easily seen by a person who is in a higher dimension. Now, next question comes: can he change that also? So possibly he can change that also. If he knows what is there, what is going to happen, he may be able to change also. Okay. So now. Scientists are what you call as what they call as string theory. String theory is a branch of science. They say about 9 to 12 dimensions are there. I don't know if it's 9 or 12, but nine,
12, yes.
12 dimensions are there. Okay. So now what are these 12 dimensions? We cannot visualize because we can only think in terms of three dimensions plus time. So in these 12 dimensions, is there a being who is in 12 dimensions? Definitely there a being in 12 dimensions. So now they can see the lower dimensions easily. They can. Okay. And now when we go to the higher dimension, can we go to higher dimension? We can.
So is there any possibility in future we can go to the higher dimension?
Not in future, now.
No.
When you meditate, you go in the higher dimension only. Meditation means dropping the mind and body. When you stop, when you drop the mind and body, you are dropping the three dimensions, the time and space, right? So when you go to deep sleep, what happened to you?
I'm not aware.
Time, what happened to time? The time flies. You may sleep for 2 hours or 3 hours and you say, still I slept like half a minute. Because the time is gone, the time dimension of time is gone, dimension of space is gone. You are not able to see any other thing, right? So time and dimension, time and space disappears in deep sleep. So the four dimensions what you speak of have gone is gone in that deep sleep. Now, is there a way to go beyond these four dimensions? That's what is called meditation. In meditation, you are fully aware, but you are not there in three dimensions of four dimensions. Okay. Now, what you understand and what you see there is, has it got some relationship to what you see here? No. There are different structures. Okay. You may see here a building. Okay. So now, when you go to a higher dimension, the building may disappear. It is, the building is there, but something else is there. right? Because there's a different dimension. Okay, to give an example, a plane is flying. Okay, a plane is flying, then when you see the ground level, ground, everything looks small, 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 small things. Okay, a big mountain also looks very small. Why? In the, from that height. Similarly, when you go to the higher dimension, whatever you see in this dimension may disappear into different structures. Okay. But can you go to higher dimension? You can go. That's called meditation. And can you get some wisdom from that dimension? You can get that. That's what is called, that wisdom is called, what you call as, Ritam Parapradna. So higher wisdom. That's what Ramanujam did. He goes into the dimension, understands something mathematical, some new mathematical things, and comes back. That's what probably Einstein or somebody has done, scientists have done. Then they go into higher dimension, they understand the universe in a different way. And they explain to you in three dimensions.
Yes.
So, beyond fourth dimension is the God? Or
God is supposed to be 12 dimensions or more than 12 dimensions.
Ashtavakra.
So, let's say, like I understand, when time is just a dimension in fifth dimension or fourth dimension, you can access linear time. But then, as you go to higher dimensions, there are possibilities of time. Like, it's a Schrodinger's cat question. Like, unless you observe it, you never know what is the state of the cat. Right. So, in singularity, there is everything in one place, every possibility of every being is there in one place.
See, there's the actuality collapses into possibility in one way, in the quantum space. But before that collapse into the quantum space, probably the dimensions come into picture. Dimensions are also, it's not actually dimensions, the multiple dimensions already collapsed quantum states.
Correct.
Okay, which means there are actualities. The three dimensions, one actuality. Four dimensions, one actuality. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 dimensions are also another actuality of that quantum space.
Okay.
Probably that quantum space itself is beyond that actuality.
Correct. Correct. Awesome.
So love is also dimension?
Love before marriage or after marriage?
Love and love.
Watching too many movies.
I'm watching too many movies. No, to define what she is asking.
She's asking for universal love.
She's defining that.
Yeah.
Now I want to understand what is this universal.
Marriage
now. Om Shanti.
So I was giving this example to kids, like an apple will always think in a 2D space that it's a slice. So it will keep on changing the shapes depending on its position in the 2D space.
Right.
It will never realize that it's an apple.
So
suddenly if you look at it from three-dimensional perspective, it will make sense.
Yeah. So what do you do with this knowledge? If this is understanding, okay. So with this understanding, what do you do?
Just to know.
Just know, by knowing what will happen. Can you change some future? You can. Can you change the past? Possibly you can. If you are able to go into higher dimension, you can do that.
this is what is then mentioned in Yoga Sutra, then you should do it for welfare of.
Who should do for welfare of?
As in, once you have understood all these things, then you can think of it as a global compassion and global welfare, that you'll do anything in that direction.
In that direction. See, the thing is, even the direction of flow of the global welfare and all those things are concepts, right?
That's true.
So you are in beyond 11th dimension.
Who, me? You mean who, me? Yeah. I have only 3 dimensions. That to 1 dimension, I am trying to reduce it.
No, probably you can change past or future.
Of what?
For anything.
Why should I change? The present is what is comfortable.
Changing the future of Tech Mahindra.
What?